organizations do not get much bigger than the Associated Press. That's why Kathleen Carroll has been so influential in the journalism world. But after 14 years at the top of the AP, Carroll is stepping down. During her leadership as executive editor, the AP won a host of accolades, including 5 Pulitzer Prizes, 6 George Polk Awards, and 15 Overseas Press Club Awards. Now, filling Carroll's shoes is Sally Busby, an AP insider since 1988. She has served as a reporter, the AP's Middle East regional editor, and most recently, Washington bureau chief. And Sally joins me now from Washington. First of all, congratulations.
Thanks so much. Really appreciate it.
Now, since you've been head of the bureau there in Washington, you've been in charge of election coverage. What is the lesson of this month, this shocking election result, and now the first couple of weeks of a President-elect Trump administration?
I think it's very important for news organizations to cover the world as the world exists, be flexible, be nimble, and be on top of what actually happens. On election night, certainly many people were very surprised, but we were able to look at the facts, look at the empirical data, look at the vote count as it was coming in, and be really pretty aggressive and speedy about calling the race and pivoting to the person who actually won the election. It's very important for news organizations to not think that they know exactly better than the voters, better than the public, and really be very responsive to what is actually happening in the country.
Do you think you'll rely on polls a little bit less in the future as a result of the polls not quite getting it right this time?
Yeah, I mean, obviously that is one of the key questions of this campaign season. We try very hard to always use polls as one very critical data point in campaign coverage, but not make the horse race and the polls the entire focus of our campaign coverage. We did issues coverage this campaign season. We did accountability reporting and fact checks. We tried to talk to voters. But I think it's fair to say that everyone is going to be redoubling and retripling their efforts to go beyond polling in future elections. There's just no question about that.
This week, Donald Trump, of course, met with the New York Times. We talked about that earlier this hour. Has he sought a similar meeting with the AP? Are you interested in sitting down with him?
Absolutely. We're completely interested in sitting down with the president-elect in all formats, in video, in text. He has actually been fairly, outreachy toward the press. We definitely have concerns about access. There's no question about that. We are sort of taking a one-step-at-a-time approach, trying to sort of make the campaign conditioned to some of the expectations around access and trying to get as much information from him as we can. He does talk to reporters. It's not, during the course of the campaign, he talked to reporters.
He loves reporters. He reads it all the time.
He absolutely does. Yeah. Absolutely does. And it's almost a little throwback to a past generation where he's a little bit less controlled, and he actually will do some outreach and talk to reporters. And so I think that is one thing that is a positive. We do have a lot of concerns, though, about just sort of the normal access that the public has become used to in terms of seeing their president, letting reporters travel along with the president, that sort of thing. I think there's a fundamental misunderstanding. This is not a perk that journalist organizations are trying to get. This is actually sort of the eyes of the public, so that if there's a national crisis, people know, the public knows where the president is at any given time and knows what's going on with
him. A lot of Trump supporters on Twitter have said to me, you guys have to earn access. You have to earn his respect. You're saying absolutely not. This is not a privilege. This is not a perk of the job.
Right. I really try to keep this as not something that is a privilege for the press. This is really about accountability for the public. Does the American public and the global public get to know where the president is, what is happening in the president's daily work life, who he or she is talking to? Those are really the core foundational issues that I think access is about. And sort of putting it into the reporters being offended is a very wrong way to think about it, I think, actually.
How optimistic or pessimistic are you about covering a Trump administration? You know, we heard commentators all year say, this is now a post-truth America, a post-fact world. Do you agree?
The Associated Press and myself do not agree that this is a post-factual world. I actually do not think that that is the case at all. I think you see that when people make important decisions in their lives, they seek out objective factual information.
Sounds like some wishful thinking to me, Sally. A lot of people seem to have checked out of journalism, especially conservatives.
I think that when people actually make decisions about the things they care about in their life, they do seek out truth. Now, there is no question that people are going to sort of news organizations and voices that in some ways reinforce what their beliefs are. But, I mean, we did not really see that much downtick in information, people being interested in information, people being interested in news. I think what this was about more was that the voice that a lot of journalism is being told in seems to people to be too elitist, too out of touch with the reality that they face. And I do think that's something that news organizations need to work on. But I do not think we believe in a post-factual world.
So you're starting on January 1st. What's your top priority when you take over?
Well, I think that the new administration in the U.S. does actually provide a pretty good opportunity for the AP to do very strong accountability journalism, but also to be very fair and even-handed and objective toward the new president. So I think that's going to be a very high priority to do a good
indeed,
job.
But, you know, you used to cover the Middle East. Are you expecting a more authoritarian climate in Washington?
That, you know, I think that the American public is going to be watching very closely. I don't think that, I mean, there's no indication at this point that we're going to be looking at sort of Mideast style governance in the U.S.
You're going to learn from your time in Cairo and apply it to Washington.
You have to hold officials accountable. You have to be open-minded. You have to talk to the public and see what's actually on the mind of the society. You know, in Egypt, were people upset with the authoritarian government? What was their actual mindset? Mm. I think all of those lessons are very, very applicable.
Right now, we've only heard from Donald Trump. It'll be another thing when we actually see what he does. That'll be the real story.
Actually think it'll be a fascinating presidency to cover.
Absolutely. Sally, thank you so much. Up next here, how a Trump victory is giving a shot in the arm to not-for-profit news organizations. Hear how they're going to be spending the money right after this.